Well, 2019, I thought nature's gonna leave us alone. Oh, winter's froze us and buried us and summer baked us and soaked us. But it was those transition seasons, those forgotten seasons of spring and fall that it seemed to have all the weather action. I mean, this year will be remembered as the year of the big flood. In Ottawa, at a river, it was the most unprecedented flood in terms of magnitude and duration and impacts. We saw flooding in the Beauce region of Quebec and in the cottage country in Ontario and down near the lower Great Lakes. And the St. John River Basin, I mean, the flooding second time in 2 years, but this was one of the longest. This year was tough, I think, for farmers, real challenging. I mean, especially in the West, it was cool. It was dry, record dry at the beginning, and then the rains came and farmers were really happy, but then, my gosh, they couldn't turn the faucet off. And at the fall, they had one of the wettest, rainiest, snowiest fall. I mean, today there are millions of hectares out there on the prairies that are still waiting to be harvested, and they won't be until next year. This was the year of the big power outage. Think about it, the fact that in British Columbia, Manitoba, Nova Scotia, those utilities have never seen such outage in their entire history. This was the year of the big storm. We had the wicked weather witch of Halloween that spoiled Halloween for millions of children in Quebec, Ontario, and New Brunswick. We saw Hurricane Dorian, I mean, that absolutely annihilated Bahamas, but still had enough fuel and to arrive in Nova Scotia and create the worst public infrastructure loss in their history. It was also in the north we saw some really strange things. Oh yes, the big warmth led to the big melt, but what I saw I've never seen before was weather that was different. We had heat waves. We had forest fires you could see from space. We had a tornado in the Northwest Territories. We saw lightning and thunder within sight of the North Pole. So, hey, if you'd like to learn a little bit more about the top 10 weather stories, well, hey, stay tuned. I'm David Phillips of Environment and Climate Change Canada.